in the game.
It is a featherweight matchup between Conor McGregor and Max Holloway.
Gingerly on his leg, and one big tell that you're starting to really do well with your leg kicks is when your opponent starts to switch stances.
Right.
Watch for a stance switch very soon.
Oh, tagged him with that right hand. There, he could be in trouble.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad. He doesn't know if he's in the octagon or at his mama's house for Thanksgiving. Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. Knock him out. The fight's done.
Unable to connect it. Oh, that's a big connection there from McGregor, DC.
I mean, big strike landed for Ireland's favorite son, Conor McGregor.
So we cross the 30-second mark in our opening round.
All right, 20 seconds to go in the round. Ooh, blocks the shot.
Real quick leg kick.
That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, here we go with our second round now. Conor McGregor versus Max Holloway. Oh, nice connection with that punch. It's one thing to have an edge and reach. It's another to take advantage. Nicely done.
Nice kick.
Big knee there. Oh! All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to get behind by it.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Both fighters get up now. Oh, that's a good strike there by Max Blessed Holloway. Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Conor.
Fantastic takedown.
Up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now, the ground and pound starts.
Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. Just reached the midway point of the fight. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is with his motions on the mat. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty for this position.
Holloway's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs
now
of
struggle. Now he'll try to start attacking a rear naked choke from the top position. He is doing a really good job of relaxing, not panicking because he's getting choked.
His opponent's got double hooks in now under the chin.
It's starting to get deep. Yeah, notice he just took the body triangle, readjust the lock, and now it looks like he's got it.
All right, full guard now, DC.
And for the guy on top, he needs to build posture or just go to the next position, start shoving that knee through, trying to get the half guard, which in turn will lead to more opportunities for advancement. But if you're on the bottom, you need to be anticipating. You need to be framing. Moving, looking for opportunities to either reverse the position or get back to your feet.
Beautifully timed and placed kick there by Conor. Oh, he lands a hook there, DC. That was one of his...
Oh! Oh, he got it back!
Oh, big left hook there! Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter, and I thought he did a good job of doing just that. Well, another highlight for the real DC as we look back at that scintillating knockout.
Yeah, but the whole fight, he was landing great strikes and kicks.
Now we go inside the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Soon I'm about to rise. judge me. Name so pep, I bun your mouth if you speak, so follow me.
All right, coming up next, a featherweight matchup between Max Holloway and Jose Aldo. Jose Aldo and Max Holloway. Legacies are on the line here tonight, two of the greatest featherweights of all time. In terms of adjustments, you gotta feel like Nova Liao and Jose Aldo's team have made some as they try to solve this Holloway puzzle.
Well, they have to. When you're down 2-0 against one opponent, you gotta make adjustments or you don't get many more opportunities. I'm sure him and his coaches have worked diligently to ensure that he's able to get his hand raised in this fight.
Aldo's head kick looked like that one was blocked.
Nice strike. Beautiful body kick land right under the elbow.
Nice jab, follows up with a nice right hand. Just over 3 minutes to go. Lands the right hand. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop him. John, stop him. That's a big strike right there.
Oh, misses with the jab. So just over 20 total strikes and counting. And now landed for the King of Rio, Jose Aldo. Oh, and he lands yet another uppercut. So those strikes have come in bunches tonight, really starting to find some consistency.
Finding consistency because he knows that that is a strike that he can find at any time. He's so confident in finding that uppercut that it's landing over and over again.
Oh, a strong punch there by Holloway. Oh, beautiful combination there from Max Holloway, the West Express firmly on the track tonight.
Once he's rolling, Max Holloway is a world problem. And right now, he's got everything working for him.
Landed that overhand right.
Looks like Pac-Man has taken so many strikes to the head.
Back and forth we go. And a nice job at least staying upright on that. All right, so he's landed a few big uppercuts already, and DC, I know you're in the prediction business. You think he's gonna set it up again?
I am certain he's gonna try and set that up again. Expect it to come off of a left hook, because off the left hook, don't anticipate the next punch coming right up the middle. He's real good at trying to find that shot. Look at him whip his hip into that kick. Oh.
Oh, big left hook there. Round two coming up next. Let's get you some of the action from that previous round, DC. And those are some serious leg kicks, man.
He gets the leg to the target so quickly. He gets his foot off the ground so quickly that you don't even recognize that it's coming. And that's really confusing his opponent.
Is now upon us. Pretty competitive first 5 minutes, I thought.
It's exactly what we expected. We expected, we saw this on the match sheet, that these two guys are evenly matched. Let's see who really takes control as we go into the second round.
And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if he can follow it up.
He landed that punch over and over again. What's he gonna do to follow up?
All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-piece, there's no soda. More often than not, it's one and done.
He's not even getting a combination. I mean, if you're gonna sit there at the drive-thru, order a combination, take the soda with your food, give him the right hand behind the jab, give him the hook behind the right hand. Jab, right hand, hook, two pieces of chicken and a biscuit. Finish him off with the uppercut. That is your soda. I mean, come on, man. Let this guy have the whole thing.
So 50 total strikes have landed for Jose Aldo.
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Oh, big left. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Oh, nasty cut there, right on the bridge of the nose. So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his... He's rocked.
That was a beautiful hook. It landed perfectly, and it hurt his opponent very bad.
Ooh, found a home for that knee. Aldo gets hit with a kick here. That one landed flush. Let's see if he can make some adjustments. Holloway's got his arm under the chin, going for a guillotine now.
Oh, he's stuck in the guillotine.
Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold. And it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold it.
Know when to fold it. Yep, absolutely.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long working on a guillotine. He may try to hip escape. All right, well, he continues to manhandle here on the ground. Now maybe trying to get to a choke position here, DC. Well, he had a lot more than a puncher's chance coming in. Big knockdown for him in the previous round, DC. All right, next round is now underway. I thought there was pretty good back and forth action in the previous frame.
Yes, it wasn't a far fight. It wasn't two guys throwing the kitchen sink at each other. But you did see times where they came together and you saw the skill level of these two fighters. What a punch.
Oh!
He needs to start looking. Wow.
Good work here by Aldo.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here, and he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
He needs to move.
Yeah, he's got to move, John. He's got to shrimp and try to either get up or pull his opponent back into him so he doesn't have the posture to land that big damage.
Oh, it looks like he's transitioned to an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys. He's going to tag armbar here. Why is he not recognizing this right now? He's got to recognize this is dangerous. This is a dangerous position. Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Oh, that was a violent tap there, so he submits him with the arm bar.
I mean, just steps ahead of the competition where you're playing checkers, he's playing chess in the ground fighting, and it showed tonight in this big submission victory. He got him!
Yeah, really impressive work out of him here tonight. He had to work for it, no doubt about it, but a nice job to isolate and ultimately secure the arm and then get the tap from the arm bar. So a pretty submission finish turned in by that fighter here tonight. All right, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
I mean, you know, this guy has such a great submission game that you cannot lay in his guard. He's so skilled, he's so tricky, and he's so good at weaving a web that gets you lost in it that he made him pay for it tonight and got the submission victory.
I'm on top of the world.